We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Ought to be a good one here between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Houston Astros. And that will bring in Yandy Diaz. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Now here's the pitch.
One of my favorite pitches in the game right there. The old Greg Maddux equalizer. Start it at the front hip and bring it back.
And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now. 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2. But when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Another full count pitch home. Fouled off. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. So coming to the plate, Brandon Lau, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
That is third. The third baseman.
Joey. To the plate now, Joey Wendell. Popped him up. Maldonado shading to his right. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. So a runner at first with two away, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. Lau is off of first with two away. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Reddick will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Into the box, George Springer. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 home. Just catches the inside corner for strike two. On a good curveball, gets him swinging for route number one. Next up for the Stros, Alex Bregman. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Now the 1-1 pitch takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Now that's when you know it's a good pitch. He broke off a really nice breaking ball down in the zone right there. And even though this is one of the best hitters around, he waved right through it.
The 2-2. One out, nobody on. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Kiermaier is right there. Two gone. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. To two balls and two strikes now. Two out, nobody on. He pulled the string a bit too sharply there on a curveball as it's down around the shoe tops.
You know, we'll see him work both sides of the plate with his curve.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Hunter Renfroe, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. Nope. High and wide. Two balls and a strike. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Now the payoff pitch home. Base hit into right center. Into the box now, Willie Adames. Yanked on the ground down the line. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out. Up next for the Rays, Kevin Kiermaier. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Little chopper back to the mound. And no shot to recover on the throw to first, and there are two on as we'll see how this is scored. Standing in now, Manuel Margot. Breaking pitch, and this bounces in front of the catcher. Now a flare out toward right center. Reddick coming on. He can't get there as it falls in. And a good throw is going to hold that runner at third, so they're loaded now with only one away. Stepping in now, Mike Zunino. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1. Unlikely had ball four that time, but couldn't hold back on the swing, so that moves the count to 3-2 now. Now the payoff pitch home.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch. And another foul ball. It misses, ball four, and that will force home a run. Stepping into the box, Yandy Diaz. He was a strikeout victim to open up the ball game. Here now the 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Tucker waits on it, and he makes the play, but this should extend their lead as the runner tags from third. And the run is in to score from third. It's a 2-0 ball game. So striding forward now, Brendan Lau. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes to an end. So here's Yuli Gurriel. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Well, this is gloved over there at first as he was in the right spot at the right time. One away. So the base is empty here with one away, and in to hit next will be the outfielder Kyle Tucker. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. 1-1. Line drive to center field. That gets down, and the inning continues. So that keeps the bottom of the second going.
That is the right fielder.
In now, Josh Reddick. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Reddick waiting and out the pitch. Fouled away. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. Makes the catch and that'll retire the side. Standing in, Joey Wendell, 0-for-1 after a pop-out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Driven the other way, but caught down at third. Definitely well hit, but the leadoff man's retired to start the third. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Austin Meadows. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third. So two are gone here in the Tampa Bay third inning, and that'll bring up outfielder Hunter Renfro. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Here it comes. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Leading off the inning, Aledmys Diaz, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. The 1-2. Drilled right back up the middle. And this will find its way into center field for a leadoff single. So now to the plate, Martin Maldonado. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. Here's George Springer. He went down swinging to start the home first. A 1-1 is taken for ball two. Swing and a miss, 2-2 now. From the belt, the pitch. To second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and up next will be Willie Adames.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Hit down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. So digging in now, Kevin Kiermaier. Now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. And he misses again. Ball three.
Well, this next pitch is a big one. The last thing you want to do is give a free pass to a guy that can run like this. He's a real burner out there on the base paths.
In time to first, and there are two away. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. 1-1 home.
Ball right there.
little too tall that time. 3-1 now. And that one misses. It's ball four. So a two-out walk gives the Rays some hope here in the inning.
Up next for Tampa Bay.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Mike Zunino. Man at first after the two-out walk. Throw is up the line as it gets away. Popped him up. Maldonado waits on it. And that retires the side. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Drilled down the line. Well, this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a ground ball to third, but foul. And he fouls this one off.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. No runs, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count. It's yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
But quick hands over there at third as he takes it for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. The 1-2. Down the left field line and deep. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2 misses for the second ball.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
Still 2-2. Fiftieth pitch of the game on its way. High chopper to third. Another try at 2-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. So Tampa's batting order turns over and set to go. Yandy Diaz earned himself an RBI with a sac fly his last time at the plate. Two balls and a strike to the Rays first baseman. Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1. Here's the pitch. Hard hit ball to short. And this will get through into left for a leadoff hit.
Number 8.
Into the box, Brandon Lau. Ground ball right side. There's one. Return throw gets him at first. It's a 3-6-1 double play. Into the box now, Joey Wendell. He started out the evening 0-for-2 so far. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. The 1-2. Grounded up the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Driving in for Houston, Kyle Tucker. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 3-1. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway. Here's Carlos Correa now. 1-for-1 after a single this first time up. A 1-1 home.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
No runs, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Curveball got him swinging for the first down. So here's Josh Reddick.
Now batting, the right fielder, Josh Reddick.
The 3-1 pitch. 3-2 now. Runner at first here, one man out. And it's fouled away. Another one sent foul. And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away. So striding in, Aledmys Diaz. He reached on a single in his first try.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
He'd like to see a little bit more discipline.
There's a swing and a drive, and everybody's just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no doubt home run. Into the box now, Martin Maldonado. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher. Three runs already home here. And he held up in time, but it's strike three called, and there are two down. So bases are empty here with two gone, and former World Series MVP George Springer bats next. 1-1, here it comes.
Now for four innings, he was great, but here in the fifth, he looks like a completely different guy out there. That happens a lot when a pitcher is facing batters for the second or third time in a game.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Back goes Kiermaier to the track. Gone! At the plate, Alex Bregman. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
Wow, another curve here that he can't seem to find the zone with. He's really had his share of troubles with location so far this inning.
And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Margot's there to put it away and finally put an end to the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Austin Meadows. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Now the pitch. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Now that's
striding forward now is the DH, Hunter Renfro. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Even 2-2 count to Hunter Renfro. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Rays DH. And through 5 1/3, already coming up on 100 pitches here.
Yeah, Matty B, this pitch count continues to go up, 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 near 100 pitches here. He's not even through the sixth inning. And Mark DeRosa, this is right where you'd like to have a pitcher like this guy.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of stress pitches for him, you know. Usually you can throw 100 pitches, and if you're not taxed and there's not people in runners in scoring position, you could be all right. But he's had to grind this one.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. Brad Peacock takes over here with the runner at first and two gone in the inning. Standing in now, Kevin Kiermaier. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
Now back, left field.
At the plate now, Manuel Margot. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Bouncer up the middle. To first, but it's too late as the first base umpire says they just missed getting him at the bag. Stepping in now, Mike Zunino. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. This is on the ground to short. Is he going to get out of this? Over to first. He does get out of it, and the inning is over. Brendan McKay enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for Tampa Bay, number 49.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and striding forward, the designated hitter, Michael Brantley. Ripped down the first base line, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Here's the pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. Meadows is back and he reaches up to put it away for a long out number one. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Yuli Gurriel, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-2. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And there's out number two. Ready for another chance, Kyle Tucker. Bases are empty here with two men out. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against a modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. The next 3-2. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Cionel Pérez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 52.
Standing in, Yandy Diaz. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Brandon Lau. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least. So you know he wants to make up for it right here.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Brandon Lau goes down for out number two in the top half. A little early and now it's even at 2-2. Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Popped him up. Bregman over to his right. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. A 1-1. Line drive to center field. Kiermaier is right there, one down. So one gone in the inning, and that brings up the right fielder, Josh Reddick. Into right field, that's a base hit. The plate now, Aledmys Díaz. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him, 1-2.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Fouled off. Runners on first with one down. 2-2 pitch is fouled away. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate. And he misses with that one down and in. It's a full count now, 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Now batting, catcher, Martin.
Into the box now, Martin Maldonado. And here's one that misses to the Houston catcher. It's 2-1 now. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? The second for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Enoldi Paredes has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Austin Meadows. Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two. Hit hard up the middle, and that's through for his first base hit in this one. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard. So now to the plate, Hunter Renfroe. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Ani gets him to wave at that one. It's 2-2.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Tucker waits on it. One down. And this throw gets away from him. Now batting, Willie Adames. He singled his last time up.
Willie Adames.
Throw over to the bag. Throw is up the line as it gets away. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Sliced hard on the ground. Díaz scoops it up. One there over to Gurriel for an inning-ending double play. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that brings in George Springer.
Yeah, Matt, that last one wasn't exactly a tape measure shot, but listen, a home run is a home run. I know a lot of pitchers, they call that a wall scraper in his last AB, but listen, it counts as a home run nonetheless.
Had a good cut there, but he can't time the breaking ball. That evens us at 2-2. Fastball called, strike 3, and there's the first out of the inning. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. Right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
Hey, there aren't too many power hitters in the game that would let that pitch go by.
Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
The designated hitter.
Here's Michael Brantley. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. He stays alive, still 2-2. Fouled away. Good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
And Brantley will reach. He's got a base hit. So with that, we're not done with the bottom of the eighth quite yet. Into the box, Yuli Gurriel. And he fouls this one off. Popped him up. And he will indeed make the play in foul territory to retire the side. Ryan Pressly comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next.
Looking for base runners here as they're down two playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
The count now at 2-1. All even now, 2-2. Now here it comes. Hit out towards second. Diaz brings it in. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. Two hits and two trips for him thus far.
Margot.
Too high, and that cost him ball four. Digging in, Mike Zunino. 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far.
Mike.
Now the 2-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
That's exactly the pitch you don't want to be chasing in these situations. He's going to keep that ball down below the hollow of the knee, try and get you to ground into a double play. You have to set your sights at least belt high.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Mike Zunino goes down for the second out, and now they're down to their final try. Set to deliver on 2-1. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Back goes Reddick, and he tracks it down. And this ball game is over.
Hey, it always feels good to win a baseball game, but when you can win one at home in front of your home crowd, all those fans cheering, this is a good win for this team.
Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close two-run victory. Well, heroes are made in the postseason, and he was at least the hero in this one. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, no time like the postseason to come through and lift your team to victory. He was certainly a big factor here, and it was pretty cool to see.
4-2 the final score tonight. The Houston Astros even up this division series at one game apiece. Framber Valdez is the winning pitcher of record. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Rays, 2 runs, 9 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 46 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Minute Maid Park, 41,168. The Astros thank you for attending and remind you to please drive home safely. Good night.